Hi, I'm William O'Brien, and this is Mouthskin and Vlog, Episode 7, Part 2. That's right, Part 2. There's a Part 1. You haven't seen it yet? What are you doing watching Part 2? Okay, I understand if you're a rebel. That's cool with me. Whatever. More power to you, man. Or, well, man. So, here are the stories to look out for in this episode. Part 2 of the Monstrous News. A new parade coming to the Magic Kingdom. A new character spot coming to the Animal Kingdom. And I'll talk about my Disney trip. Well, without further ado, here we go. Here's part 2 of that Monstrous News. Like I said last week, there was an announcement of Monstrous Summer made by none other Mike Wazowski on Spaceship Earth at Epcot at the big announcement. Now, here's part 2 of that announcement. At Magic Kingdom, there's an attraction called Monsters, Inc. The Laugh Floor, where it's kind of an interactive show with Mike Wazowski, some new monsters to do, comedy bits with people in the audience. Now, it's been the same show ever since it opened. Now, because of the whole Monsters University, they're going to have new jokes and new comedy bits, finally. I like the old show, but new things are always good. Especially with this show. Can't wait to see what's happening with there. Now, at Hollywood Studios, that's why I'm wearing this Indiana Jones hat, where the meet and greet next to the back lot tour, the exit of the back lot tour, you could meet Mike Wazowski and Sully from Monsters, Inc. at the scare floor, right in front of Boo's door. Now, because of Monsters University, you need to go to the student lounge. And, Mike Wazowski is wearing the Monsters University cap, and Sully is wearing his, Monsters U Letterman jacket. They look pretty cool together like that from this new movie. If any of you get a chance to go down there, please take a picture of it and send it to me so I can show it in my next episode and or vlog. That's all for the Monsters News. What's next? So here's that story about, the new parade at Magic Kingdom. Sadly, at the end of this year, make a dream come true parade. Dreams come true parade. It's going away. Kind of like Mickey's Damon Jungle. But no worry, there's going to be a replacement for Dream Come True Parade. It's going to be called Festival of Fantasy Parade. And here's the information about it. The Disney Festival of Fantasy Parade will bring a celebration of new Fantasyland to Main Street, USA through fantastic and innovative new parade floats, vibrant costumes, an original soundtrack that will feature beloved songs from favorite Disney films, plus a parade theme song. This parade will specifically highlight the stories of The Little Mermaid, Sleeping Beauty, Dumbo, Pinocchio, Peter Pan, Tangled, and the Disney Pixar film Brave, among others. Sounds really cool. I saw the pictures of the new floats, and they look amazing. If you want to find out any more information on this parade, I say at least Google it and type in Festival of Fantasy Parade to see the floats. But it's supposed to open up in spring of 2014. So, I think actually that's around the same time the new ride, the Seven Dwarfs Mine Ride, opens up. So it's going to be a great year next year, but it's also going to be a great year this year. It's not even over yet. We still have a lot to go. So what's the next story? Okay, here's a story about the Adventurer's Outpost. But before I talk about that, there's actually some character news I want to talk to you about. Well, Eeyore will be leaving the Animal Kingdom at the closing of the park on May 9th, which means that Eeyore will only be available at the Crystal Palace at Magic Kingdom or training meets. Winnie the Pooh and Tigger will move into Camp Minnie Mickey. Pooh and Tigger will move into camp on May 10th. Now, Donald and Daisy will move into Discovery Boat Island Dock, where the Pooh characters are currently meeting. This will be returned to Animal Kingdom for Daisy, who used to meet during lunch in Camp Minnie Mickey. This area will offer fast pass once the system is completed. That's kind of true because I met Daisy, which I'll show you later, at the breakfast at Tusker House. But I guess this is the first time you'll be able to actually meet her without actually going to the breakfast. Minnie and Mickey will move into the all-new Adventures Outpost beginning May 12th, as predicted earlier. This offers guests another indoor air-conditioned meet and greet for Mickey. It hasn't been announced if they will meet as a couple or separate. It'd be kind of interesting if Minnie and Mickey are the only characters that will be there. Hopefully more. Be cool to see, you know, Flick and Princess Anita, I think her name is, from Bug's Life, there too, rather than just that limited time magic thing for the parade for Animal Kingdom's 15th anniversary. Yeah, now it's time to tell what happened on my Disney trip. Okay, now it's time to do one thing I like to do a lot, is talk about Disney. Well, actually, I'd like to talk about Disney, and you like Disney, or you want to be watching this video. It's actually talking about my Disney trip. That's where I got these little ears. Big ears, actually. So, here we go. Rather than just telling you about it, I'm going to show you the pictures, too. Okay, open it up. So, start out with, I stayed at the Pop Century. If you haven't stayed at the Pop Century, you need to. It's a great great resort. It's the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. I stayed in the 50s and 60s, actually just the 50s, but the last few times I stayed in the 70s. Don't get me wrong, I like the 70s and all, but I'm crossing my fingers to stay in the 90s. Come on, the 90s were such a great year. What's next? Went to Downtown Disney, got my ears. I was searching for them. That's one of my main things to get when I went down there. And then there's actually a store at Downtown Disney called The Art of Disney, where a lot of artists do their own rendition on Disney characters, movies, and I met this cool guy. He was actually drawing him right there, Tim. He's a great guy, and he actually knows the voice of Mickey now. He was actually a roommate with Brett. That's his name, Brett. I thought, that's really cool. So I did my Mickey voice for him, and he said, that's really good. That's really, really spot on. Tell me about how Brett got into the business and how he got in the business. And actually, I'll show you the picture. It's a pretty dang good picture. If I do say myself, well, for him, actually. But he said, let's keep connected. And so we're connected now. What's next? Oh, we went back to the Pop Century after all our fun there. And actually got to meet up with my friend Steve, which I made friends with him like a few years back on my first day at Pop Century. Just talking, he encourages me. He's a great friend, a great cast member. He's actually in the top 10%, I think. Word of advice, if you ever see a cast member with the Walt and Mickey statue on their pin, I would ask for questions to them or tell them they're doing a great job, but way to go, Steven. Here's your shout out. Okay, what's next? Oh, then I went across the river to see the Art of Disney. There's me and Rafiki. Squatch Banana. That's actually my girlfriend, one of my girlfriend's favorite characters. And then Sheriff caught me from Cars. Then I met everyone's favorite tow truck, Mater. Then had to meet Lightning Queen, ka-chow! And then the next day we went to Magic Kingdom. And when we entered in, Pluto was going to get a drink of water. I'm like, Pluto, there you are, boy! Huh? I actually stopped him in his tracks. And I'm like, oh, I gotta meet him now. I know how I usually do just 4 stories per episode. But here is a bonus story! Woo! Okay, the reason this bonus story is because, well, it's happening soon. May 4th is the unofficial Star Wars Celebration Day. It's because it's May the 4th be with you. Anyway, well, starting soon is going to be Star Wars Weekends at Hollywood Studios. And, well, the first time ever, Disney's actually celebrating it, too, for May the 4th Be With You. They're going to have, like, special events, like the new Star Tours ride. The characters are actually going to ride it with you. You can ride next to Chewbacca or, maybe C-3PO. That'd be a little trippy, C-3PO there. Or Darth Vader. There'll be dance parties at the night. Parents and kids can both do the Star Wars Jedi training. Wish I could make it. If any of you do make it, if you please take photos and videos and please send them to me. Time to wrap the video up. Well, that about wraps it up for episode 7, part 2 of Mousekino Vlog. Kind of back to my Disney trip. If you want to see the complete 15-minute and something second video of me talking about my trip and showing you pictures, if you just have time for that or you're just completely bored and have nothing else to do, check it out on my YouTube channel. It'll just be a super video and the playlist of random MKV videos. Please follow me on Twitter at MKingdomVlog. Please check out my other videos out, give them some love too. Like and subscribe. Until next week, always remember, if you can dream it, you can do it. Bye for now.